Hello, and welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial will show you how to integrate the Lenze i950 as an AC drive profile device into an Ethernet IP control system. After connecting an Ethernet cable into the engineering port of the i950 drive, open up EC Starter and go online with the device. Make sure you have the correct IP address for the i950 you're connecting to by pinging it. Then, click Insert to connect to it. Here, we want to go into the Settings tab and change the application type to Technology Application AC Drive Profile. There are some initial parameters that you should keep in mind to set up for the i950 to operate in this mode. I put them in a list on the upper right corner of the screen here for reference. First, you want to set up your motor. For a Lenze motor, you can input the C86 code found on your motor tag and it will import all the motor characteristics correctly. Then, go to the TA AC drive profile section. Select the AC drive mode you want, speed or torque control. Afterwards, go to the interface subsection. Here, you can control the i950 through EC Starter instead of the field bus by clicking on Activate Internal Control. This unlinks the blue lines of communication here. Since I will be controlling this through the PLC today, I will leave this unchecked. Scrolling down here, you can see the speed and torque scale value. Changes here reflect the input reference speed coming from the PLC. You can see that if I were to change this value to a 1, 2 to the 1 is 2, and so the actual speed going out will be half of what is coming in. Keep in mind that this will affect the minimum and maximum speed range. So two other parameters that you should take notice of are the speed high and low limit found in the signal flow subsection here. If you have a scale value that goes above or below this limit, the motor will not go to that speed, so update these values appropriately. These parameters, of course, can be searched for in the Parameter List tab, and you can also add them to your Favorites folder for future reference. Lastly, you want to go into the Ethernet IP section to set up your IP configuration so that it can communicate with your PLC. You can do this using DHCP or manually storing a fixed IP address in the drive. Now let's move on to the PLC side. You should have an Ethernet IP EDS file downloaded from the Lenze official site. This can be found in the Engineering Data tab of the Downloads section. Afterwards, install the EDS file using the EDS hardware installation tool. The Rockwell software should now be able to recognize the i950 as a device. Right-click on the Ethernet section of the program tree and click Add New Module. Search for Lenze devices, and then click on the i95A as an AC drive device. Give it a name and some description about what you're using the device for. Then assign an IP address to it. This should be the same IP address if you give the i950 a fixed IP address in EC Starter. Then click the Change button to select the type of input and output structure. In this case, since I selected the speed mode in EC Starter, I can come here and select the basic speed mode or any other AC drive profile that includes a speed mode. If I were to select the torque mode in EC Starter, then there are only two options that have the torque mode. You can see that changing between these modes changes the size of the input and output automatically. Then, go to the Connection tab and make sure you have the cycle time you want and that the input type is unicast. After that, click OK, and you should be ready to go. I can go online, download the program, and once the program is running, I can go to the controller tags, and as an example, change the speed value. And if you go back to EC Starter, you can see that the value has been communicated to the i950. And that's it! Setting up the AC drive profile is as easy as that. See you in our next video.